Hello, I'm Richard Ridge. David Henry Hwang is back on Broadway with his new comedy, Chinglish. Under the direction of Lee Silverman, it's playing at the Long Acre Theater, and we're here on opening night to celebrate with the company.
What does this one mean? Believe it or not, Chief Financial Officer. Likely the result of a bad computer translation program.
It's such a beautifully written play, and just the whole concept of all the characters. How did you come up with the idea?
Well, I was traveling to China a fair amount on work, because China's become very interested in Broadway-style musicals. And I happen to be the only sort of Chinese person who's written a Broadway show. So I would go over for meetings, and on one trip I saw this new cultural center in Shanghai, which was gorgeous in every way, except for the really badly translated signs. And I started to think about doing a play about doing business in China, but one which would deal with the issue of language, which is something that I'd never seen attempted in a movie or a play. And so that the Chinese characters would have the dignity of their own language, and that it ended up becoming a comedy and a romance, a sex comedy.
Can you tell us about the synopsis of the play?
Sure. The play's about an American businessman who goes to the second-tier Chinese city to try to make a deal, and he discovers how much he doesn't know and all the different levels of miscommunication, language being the most superficial, but sometimes even if you know what someone is saying, you might as well be speaking a different language because the underlying cultural assumptions are so different.
Talk about your director, Lee Silverman, how she became involved with the project and what it's been like working with her.
Well, Lee was with the project from the beginning. We had done my previous play, Yellowface, together. And I told her about the idea for this play, but I hadn't actually gotten around to writing it. So she made me schedule the workshop so I'd have a deadline. And then I finished the first act, and a month later I finished the second act. And she has been my partner and collaborator in every way, just in terms of she's so smart about text, and she notices everything in the production. And I work with her a lot because I know I never have to worry about anything, and that she will really do everything she can to try to bring the vision that I had when I wrote the play to life.
There was no play when you first got involved, was there?
It was just one act. That was just one act. I can't believe it. Actually, when David first, we were working on David's play Yellowface, when he first told me he had this idea for a play called Chinglish, was going to be a bilingual comedy about an American businessman who was going to China. And I thought, okay, that sounds really amazing. What is it? You know? So he wrote this first act, and I said, this is incredible. I don't know how we would ever do it, but this sounds incredible.
So when you first read the whole play, what went through your mind?
I thought, I don't speak a word of Chinese. But, you know, I thought this is an incredible challenge and so radical to have a play with this much Chinese on a Broadway stage. I think it's so funny. It's so relevant. I think it's sexy. I think there's a real love story in the middle of it. I think you really care about these people. And I think there's nothing like it. And I think David is one of the most extraordinary writers. And I just felt so excited about what this play could be and what the potential for this production might be.
Because what I loved about the play is it's a great comedy, but this whole serious play and everything unravels as it goes by. You don't see anything coming.
Yeah, I think the play is full of surprises, and I think there's real meaning in the play. I think David's really exploring very serious content about American and Chinese relationships, about love relationships, and yet he does it in this effortless comedic envelope that is so theatrical and so surprising that it just makes it a joy, I think, to watch. And you walk out and you just think, that's incredible. And I think the play is smart. And so I just think there are few evenings in the theater like that.
Ah, Chicago.
Chicago? No, we're based in
Cleveland. Oh, your firm is based in Cleveland, but you've done business in
Chicago.
Chicago!
The
minister says.
The minister was also born in a small farming village.
Cleveland isn't exactly a farming. Though I suppose it was at one time.
So my role is Peter Timms. He is a business consultant.
who is navigating or helping Daniel, the central character, helping him navigate his way through kind of provincial China. So I speak Mandarin in the play. I've been in China for about 19 years, and I'm kind of acting as an interpreter, kind of cultural.